And welcome back on this Tuesday morning. 69 degrees out there. Grab an umbrella just in case you may see a few little showers out there. It's starting to clear out. But everything should be gone about 8:30, and then around noon, 40% chance of those thunderstorms return with high temperatures around 82. Tomorrow, thunderstorms or scattered showers still in the forecast with your high temperature of 87, and it looks like things will dry out after that. And then we've got some sunny skies, back to the pool, and all is good in the 80s. 230-4988 does get Frank this morning. Dr. Jan White with me this morning on this Tuesday morning. How are you?
Great.
What is your topic today?
Well, I'm talking about long-term care.
You know, we were talking about that. What exactly is long-term care?
Well, long-term care is an umbrella term for all different types of care, usually for older adults. And there's a big misunderstanding, even in the medical community, about the different types and different options. So first I'm going to tell the viewers the different types of long-term care, and then I'm going to give you some of the costs. So get ready for sticker
shock.
Yeah,
for shock is sure.
Yeah.
I'm just going to say, you know, we have or had long-term care on me and Jamie.
Uh-huh.
However, I canceled me because that's really a waste of money.
Yeah, it is. I agree. You're too young.
Gotcha.
Minimum 55.
All right. So when you turn 55, start definitely looking seriously into long-term care.
Right.
All right.
Okay. So the different types of long-term care. First of all is independent living.
Mm-hmm.
And independent living, they're usually apartments, and they're for people 55 and over.
Okay.
A lot of these are for low-income people. They're subsidized, and they're really great.
Is help out there.
Oh, absolutely. There's all kinds of options.
All right.
And then there's continuing care retirement communities, also known as a CCRC. What is that? That is a facility, usually it's a campus type environment where all types of care are available. So you have the independent living, and then you have the assisted living and the nursing home and everything right there on one campus. Now, on the downside, there is a very steep initiation fee, non-refundable, that can go up to $1 million.
Oh, good gosh.
You must be well. You have to bring proof of mental and physical wellness. Okay. So that is really not an option for a lot of people.
It's really unrealistic.
But they're very popular. But when you go in, because that fee is non-refundable, you're stuck. So you have to really do your homework.
Goodness.
So the next type is assisted living. Assisted living is not a nursing home. Assisted living is for someone who is still able to live in their own little apartment, but they're not doing cooking, they're not doing cleaning, but you don't need medical help. You may need help. Yeah, you may need help with getting to the toilet and with bathing. But remember, that's a type of living where you do not need to have 24-hour medical care,
okay?
Now, a skilled nursing facility, also known as a nursing home, that is where you need skilled care. You need doctors and nurses around you 24/7. Now, do you know that 34% of residents in nursing homes are not older adults?
Really?
Right. I know. There are people there are people who are younger but who have disabilities or who have had strokes and so forth and so on.
Been in car accidents, changed. And
right, and so that really surprised me.
That's a high number.
Right, that really did surprise me. So now we're going to get to the costs. Oh, and by the way, skilled nursing facilities, nursing homes, also have memory care units. And so this is where a person with dementia can go, and it's secure, it's safe.
Oh, they're safe.
Well,
they can't get out
it's secure,
and get lost.
Right. There's no wandering.
Okay.
Okay, now here's some of the costs. And by the way, keep in mind there is no Medicare fairy.
Oh, come on.
Okay,
everybody
there is a misconception that there is this fairy who is miraculously paying for all of these. No, the fairy, there's no fairy here.
So don't wait and count on
Wait and count on that Medicare fairy. Okay, so how much does a skilled nursing facility, nursing home, cost?
This ought to be interesting.
Well, the first 100 days are paid for by Medicare if you spend 3 days in the hospital. So often people go from a hospital, say they've had a major surgery, they go from the hospital
straight to
the nursing home to recover, and then they go back home. Okay. Now, for many people who are really in need of care, they have multiple chronic conditions and they need to live in a nursing home, it's different. Then it's about $248 a day for a private room and $239 for a shared room.
Gee, not much difference there.
$90,000 a year, and that's just the basic.
How do people afford that?
Well, here's how they afford it. They deplete all of their savings.
Again, how
do people? Sell all their stocks, and then they qualify usually for Medicaid, which is for the indigent, because by then you are indigent. Okay.
Lost everything.
Right. So, and there's some issues about this because you could actually be moved to a different nursing home that covers Medicaid. So you have to be very careful when you choose. Assisted living. Remember, I said that's for people who just need a custodial type of care,
right.
Non-medical. Okay. The average cost in the United States is $3,500 a month.
Okay.
Or $42,000 a year, and that's for one person, not a couple.
Oh.
Now, my mother was paying $7,000 a month.
Whew.
Because they add on things like laundry and special services, you know.
You're in the wrong business.
These are the basic costs. And then there is another option, daycare. So, for example, if your older adult parents move in, but they need to,
like someone sitting with them throughout the day?
Well, it's not sitting.
They're
usually
facility?
Picked up and they go to a place where they have activities.
Okay.
And then they come back home. So that's about $70 a day.
Okay.
So the bottom line is, yes, Gloria, you talked about this long-term care insurance.
You better just
yes,
be saving to be able
you
to take
need
care of ourselves.
Long-term care insurance and you need to save. Okay, because this is not free. This is a lot of money.
It is. So many people don't have that kind of money.
I know. Most people do not have this kind of money. So if you stay healthy and you start thinking about this now, then you can start making a plan.
And then when you talk to the insurance agents and they try to sell you that long-term insurance,
right? Shop around.
Shop around. Get prices, and don't let them sucker you into if you're a husband-wife thing and
right.
you really don't need it. Make sure
right.
you do.
Right. So and get with an agent that you really trust.
Okay.
Now there are a couple of great websites I recommend for if you're trying to make a decision about long-term care.
Okay.
The Alabama Nursing Home Association and the Assisted Living Association of Alabama. Go to those websites. They're excellent. They tell everything, good, the bad, and the ugly.
Okay. Long-term care.
Yep. And there's a lot of options, but stay healthy. That's the key.
That seems to be. We better. Gosh, can't afford to be sick and old.
Only 5% of older adults die in a nursing home, so I think that's very encouraging.
Okay. Dr. Jan White with us this morning. Thank you very much. Check out all those
You're
options,
welcome.
Too. Lots of choices to make. All right. Well, yes, this past Saturday, we were at the Hard Dock. We had a interesting time. It was a lot of fun. Bonnie and them put on a great show. The entertainment was great all the way around. We're going to share some of that video. Stay with us.
All right, let me introduce you to Rob. Now, so,
for many years now, JC has been telling me that he actually took karate, and I've been kind of skeptical. But
it's true. I was there, and we took. It's probably been 30 years ago. At Master Lee's, we took and we did the afternoon sessions. We'd go at lunchtime, and we'd go over there and did the adult session, and we did karate. He was kind of in the back of the class with the white belts or something. We were all in the front.
He could have been him
and Master Lee were like go at it, and it was like they were like dancing, you know, at the top with weapons and stuff.
It was like a fishtail, they get bigger and bigger.
It was wild, man. But we took it for about a year or so. I remember he came to class and we had a good time, yeah.
That shocks me. I can't believe it. Well, Rob, nice to meet you.
That's right. That's good.
Thank you, Rob. Thanks for coming.
I'm glad to hear that because I was kind of a little bit worried. Nah. So.
He keeps swallowing. Yeah, and they bring a stool over there and sit him down. I mean, did they just sit him down? I mean, he was kind of,
I'm here for the party.